Have you ever wondered how these renders were made? Many professional 3D artists showcase their work with wireframe and clay renders. Did you know? Do they also include those renders in their portfolio? Hello, I'm Bhagat. In this video, you will learn how to make clay, viewport and wireframe renders inside Blender. If you are new to my channel, I make videos related to 3D, beginner-friendly tutorials, tips and tricks and more. Please consider subscribing to this channel. It helps you and also me to grow together. Let's get into our video. To render the viewport, there are two methods: rendering only the mesh we created, or rendering the viewport including all the lights, camera, floor, XYZ axis, and everything that you see in the viewport. First, let me show you the second method. To render everything in the viewport, go to View and click on Viewport Render Image. It will render the area which we are currently looking at, but not the view from the camera. So, to render the view from the camera, press 0 to view the camera perspective. Again, go to View and click on Viewport Render Image. You can save this image like a regular 3D render by clicking on the image and saving it. Rendering the viewport animation also follows the same method by going to the View and Viewport Render Animation. But it is going to save it as an image sequence and automatically saves it in the temporary folder in the C drive. So in the output properties, don't forget to choose the video format and the path where the video is going to save. I'm choosing FFmpeg video. In the encoding, choose the format that you want. I'm choosing MPEG-4. Now let's see the other method. To render the mesh with solid material, you can either do it by disabling the overlay and doing the same process I said before, or by rendering it with the workbench engine. Change the render engine to workbench. Select the style you want. You need to be in the render mode to see the changes. To render the image or animation, you can follow the process which we do with EV or cycles just by going to the render tab and choosing it. Now let's see how to do the clay render. For that, you need to be in the cycles render. Add a plane. Move it out of the scene. Assign a material to it and rename it. I'm naming it clay render. Now go to view layer properties. Scroll down to the bottom and expand override. And select the material we created. Bring down the value and increase the roughness. Whatever you do to the clay render material, it is going to affect everything in the scene. To remove this effect, just remove the material from the override and render it. This is how you make the clay render. Now let's see how to render the wireframe. Select the object that you want to add wireframe, duplicate it with Shift D, and right click to snap it to the original place. Now we have two meshes overlapping. Select one of the meshes and go to modifiers and add wireframe modifier. Assign a different material to it and change the thickness of the wireframe. Hold shift to decrease it slowly. and render it. This is how you make different types of renders. If this video helped you in any way, please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.